Can I create 3D product for my Shopify store only using AI tools? Hey guys, this is Stefan, and today we will explore if AI tools good enough to create 3D products that we can use in a Shopify store. So let's get it started. I created a sample website of watches. This is a very popular topic right now. So there is a few products here that we have. Let's try to start with the watches. Let's try to take this model, and for now I only have an image. And the first step will be to create this watches in few views. It is very easy, and if you watch my previous videos, you can guess like we can use just ChatGPT for our image model, the most recent one, which is very good of understanding images and creating accurate images of the same one. What you need to do is just go to ChatGPT and just drop the image that you have and ask to create the same image on a transparent background. Okay, so let's see what will be the output. Okay, so here are the results. Quite nice. The next thing we need to do is ask to do the other views of the same image. So let's do that. We can create like right, left, or front views, as well as a back view. Also for the watches, I guess it doesn't make sense to create a completely back view, but it can be a back right or back left view, that's fine. All right, so here's the result. It is not quite accurate. As you can see, the band is not what I expected to be, but that's not a problem, because what I can do, and if you have real images, real photos of your product, you can just simply drop another reference. So here I have like another reference where the band is more prominent, and let's drop it and say wrong, please correct the band according to new. So here we go, the image now came up much more accurate and we can actually use it. So you can create more views if you think they are relevant, but I recommend to stick with 4. And again, if you have something messy or wrong, just provide more reference or instructions how to correct the image. So I already created them. So now let's do a second step. For the second step, we need to create an actual 3D model and see how good it is, right? I would recommend to use 2 of them. The first one is Hyper3D Rodin model. It's probably the best as for now when I record this video. Again, things changing quite rapidly, so maybe something better coming up already when you watch this video. But up to now, there is Rodin and there is Hunyuan 2.5. So we'll use both of them and we'll just simply take whatever best results come up, and then I will also show you how we can tweak it, and we will upload it to my demo Shopify store and see how it looks eventually, and then make a conclusion. I will just simply load the images I created. I will use alpha channel, as we created images with alpha channel. I will press generate and I will press multi view. And here on the bottom, you can experiment between few modes. There is like default, focal, and zero. So zero is probably for simple surfaces, simple objects. Focal is for quite detailed objects, and there is default. So far I tested and I really liked the default one. So let's try default one. So it will take, while we're waiting here, let's jump to Hunyuan 2.5. Again, I already explained how to use Hunyuan in my previous video. You can see what results it can get. Let's also run the generation. I will basically attach the same images. Okay, so you upload the images, you select the model. We will select 2.5 and press generate. Hunyuan 2.5 do not really have a lot of options or intermediate steps. So we'll pretty much just need to wait around 3 to 4 minutes, as it says here. So let's switch back to Hunyuan, and here we have a little bit more control. What you can see is basically intermediate step that is suggest you to check if the geometry is okay or not. I really like it right now and I don't want to make any changes, so I will just confirm it. But if you're not happy with geometry, you can redo it up to 20 times. Here you specify the views. So they can see like this one is front. This one looks more like front left, correct? And this is a back left, right? So if you're not happy with the result, how it automatically detected it, you can set the views manually and press redo. But I'm quite happy with the result, honestly. I will just press confirm. It is suggesting me the amount of polygons. If you have some limits, you want the model to be more optimized, you can manipulate it. It'd be very useful for 3D artists, but I will just add a little bit more polygons to make sure all the details are preserved and just press confirm. So the next step, finalizing the geometry, and it will actually ask us about the material. Here is the intermediate step where we can check the geometry with the normal map. It already generated the description and it will use the images for the material. You can add more for the material specifically if you have some text or something like that. But I will just press generate. I think like the default settings works good, but if you think that it doesn't follow reference enough, you can just adjust this value. And if you want material properties to be more prominent, you can adjust this value. However, from my experience, leaving it as default works actually very nice. So let's press generate and see what will be the output. All right, so boss models are ready and let's take a look. The Hunyuan model gives not the very best result, to be honest. Well, I don't know what this is, a floating red thing. I see that even though the material look quite glossy, and perhaps this is actually how it looks like, but there are a lot of details that are not that accurate. So I don't like the result this time. However, from my observation, sometimes Hunyuan might give quite interesting result that we can actually use. Let's go back to Reddit. This is why I like this model so far. I mean, probably the most accurate results. There are imperfections, of course, like some dots there that look nice here, and the backside is not accurate. However, you can experiment and try to redo material by playing with the reference frame, the PBR temperature. I want to show you another AI tool, how you, without any 3D skills, can actually adjust 3D objects with AI. So let's press confirm, so it will finalize the material, and then let's select base model, let's select GLB, let's deselect shaded, because shaded means just the color map, and we only need PBR, 2K, and let's download the model. So the third tool for today will be commonsensemachine.ai or CSM. When you go inside, they also have image to 3D, but from my review, the image from 3D is something that I'm not recommending right now. I think they have quite interesting tools. I think they do a good job, good progress, but it is not that good as Rodin right now. However, there is one very interesting tool that actually can help a lot. And this is called AI Retexture. We go here, it is only available for paid plans. But the good thing is that if you pay the paid plan, it doesn't use credits to use this tool. And you can actually play around a lot. So let's try it. You go and select the model that we just created and open it. So now you can use your mouse to navigate and rotate the model. The left button will rotate the model here and the right button will move it around. So let's try to reposition it and see what areas we don't like. So the cool thing here is that from the left side is your 3D current 3D model, and from the right side is AI generated images. And whenever you will fix the view, it will recreate an image that you can use as reference to paint on a 3D model. So you can see it actually needs a prompt, but we can actually create a prompt from the image. So how I use this tool first, you can use color brush, you can pin a color. And the very first thing you can do is just paint the areas that you don't like. Control Z also work here if you did something and you want to actually cancel it. So I will first clean the area around here. Now I will rotate it and I will wait the generation actually happen again. Okay, so I fixed it. This area, now I want to paint black the whole inner part. Okay, let's do that. Okay, and now it looks much more accurate. When you done with some basic correction, you can go back to 3D view and wait while the images will be generated. When you do basic color correction, there is another awesome tool called Image Brush, which means that it can inpaint what you see from the right side if you actually go on top of the 3D model here. So you can see when I use a brush, it basically inpaints what you can see here. I will also correct some imperfections here and on top. But moreover, you can load your image here. Like, for example, here is my back of my watches. And with the tool called Align Image, you can actually align the image with your 3D model and paint on top. It is very useful for text and logo when you want to preserve information precisely. Okay, so when you position the image, you switch back to image brush and you simply paint that area that you want to project from the image source that you provided. And that's it. I were able to paint this inside part. It's not perfect. And my generated image actually is not perfect as well. If you have photo and you need to transfer some text or something like that, this works very nice. You can adjust different settings of the image. You can try to use more tools here. You can even inpaint some areas that looks like artifacts. Now, when you're happy with all the changes, you can just press Export GLB and it will automatically save the mesh. So let's test it out. Now we can go to a product card in our Shopify store and simply just drag and drop to a media area, our GLB model that we just exported. Take a look on it on a product page. Here it is. So we need to press it and here is our 3D model. The keen eye might notice that it doesn't look that good on the materials as it was looking in Rodin. And you will be absolutely right. This has happened because when we use retexture, it only works with the color map and the other maps are ignored or dismissed. So what we need to do is open Blender. I recommend to use Blender 4.3 or higher as it supports drag and drop. Let's open Blender. You press A on a keyboard, you press X. That's so you delete and clean the scene. Now let's drag and drop our second model. When you drag and drop, you just simply don't touch any setting, just press Import GLB. Now you need to go to Shading tab. Here you will see this window. By pressing on the wheel, you can find the base color node. You can press on it, and on the left window, we just now need, this is basically our color map. What we need to do is basically save it somewhere separate. So we need to press on this Hamburg menu, image, save as, and just save it somewhere. Like I will save it to the downloads folder. As easy as that. Save as image. Fine. We close the Blender. Do not save anything. Let's open it again and do the very same thing. Press A, press X to clean the scene. Now let's drag and drop our first GLB model that we downloaded from Rodin. Let's drag and drop it like with the same way. Let's go to the shading tab again. And now by pressing on the wheel, let's move this area and delete this node from here. You can press delete button and it will be removed. What we're gonna do next is just find our texture that we saved from the previous file and just drag and drop in this window. As simple as it can be. And the very last thing, let's just connect the color output to the color input here. The only thing left is go to File, Export, and select GLTF 2.0. Boom. Now just select where you want to save it. Now you can close the Blender. Let's give it a try and compare. Now I will drag and drop my exported GLB here. Wait for it to upload. Alright, it's done. Even from the thumbnail, I can tell it looks way better. Go back to our website. Let's update the page. And here is the first model. And there's a second model. This is the model with only color map. And this is the model with materials. It looks much better. As I can see, like the materials, there are some artifacts that I didn't paint it. You can see here, here, and here. So I could definitely spend a little bit more time there playing and editing. But the whole point of today's video is to see how far we can go, like in a quick way. And as per my conclusion, let's do a summary. In my opinion, it is great that we making such a big progress. However, if you're looking to create high-end 3D models, it's not quite yet there. But The technology evolves extremely fast. In a week or two, this tool might improve many times and can provide better results. So I encourage you to take a look at it now. So whenever it works better, you can use it for your benefits right away. You can play around with ChatGPT, Hyper3D, Common Sense Machine, the Hunion models. Maybe there are another good models. Play around, see if it works, and always be one step ahead. Thanks for watching. If you find this video useful, please consider subscribe and see you in the next videos. Bye.